Hi, my loves. Thank you so much for visiting my channel. I hope that you're having a beautiful and an amazing day. This is a timeless collective reading for the sign of Aries.
You know, I'm starting to wonder if some people, if you've been watched and monitored by friends, family, strangers, and other people because they knew that you were some type of psychic, or if these things were just a part of the plan so that you would develop into a psychic. Some of you're full of some type of ancient wisdom. Okay, you're an ancient soul. Yeah, past, present, and future. I'm also been picking up a lot too about time. It almost seems like there's been a manipulation of time, inner journey, yeah, and teaching. This has something to do with time, with your ancient soul, things that you've been taught or things that you're meant to teach. Okay, there's other people who are here amongst us who know things about you and your journey. They know your past, your present, and your future. And maybe if you hadn't fully gone through your awakening, you were unaware, but now you're taking this inner journey and you're finding out more about yourself, more about where you come from, more about your family, things like that. I think that more will start to make sense. So, this energy is still, it's lingering. Pay attention to the omens. I keep seeing 10-10. Four of Pentacles. I feel like there is some type of hidden treasure that you have. Yeah, the Star. There's something that you have. When you strip down to absolutely nothing, who you are at your core, I feel, is what has everyone in an uproar. And I do feel like it's true. We've had a lot to come out about shapeshifters. What you see on the exterior, yeah. A lot of you, either you or someone that you're dealing with, is definitely some type of angel or a different type of being. And I feel like this has a lot of people, like I said, in an uproar. There's a lot of chaos and confusion and conflict, jealousy and envy, around the fact that you really are chosen. You really are this earth angel, this light worker, this healer. And you're successfully awakening to who you actually are. You are going to start receiving information and downloads, I feel, that's going to help you more. I want to know more about this Five of Wands. This is something, I'm telling you, that message I got was clear. And it's still the same energy here. It's just more details in the story. There's something here where someone feels like you're hiding a truth about who you actually are or where you come from. Or you could be dealing with a person. Okay. You could be dealing with someone, or you've met someone. This person is not as they appear to be. And I've been saying this for at least a year. Some of you need to be very careful with judging books by their cover, because you're meeting people who appear to be normal individuals. There is people amongst us who are hiding the fact that, I feel like with these stars here, they're from different places, different galaxies or something. And this is causing some type of war here, okay? This to me is more than just spiritual warfare. This seems like a battle of the galaxies. This feels like like we're in a video game. And I was saying last night, like Hunger Games almost. It's like people are trying to test you to see if you are who you say you are, or they're purposely putting you in positions to see, like I said, how you will react and respond. There's a lot of sacrificial type of energy here as well. A lot of delays have been put in place of your journey, and yet I feel like you're still victorious. The Five of Wands to the Six of Wands, you're still overcoming this. And I don't know if people are just completely in a frenzy because you are who they always thought you were. Because I'm not, this isn't about you are who you say you are, or who you say, who you told these people. You are exactly who they thought you were. And that's the problem. Yeah, Four of Swords. Clarifying the Five of Wands is the Four of Swords. These people are sick about the mysteries of who you are. That's what this is about. I feel that strongly. Like, they're like, oh, you really are who we thought you were. And I also feel, too, that there are people who have done things to you. They're very afraid now because they already know what to expect from doing something to the type of being that you are. Some of you, you're like a god. I mean, we see you, but when you strip down at a soul level, you're very high ranking. And I think a lot of people, they already know that they really have messed up big time. They know that. People are very much afraid of you. Yeah. I felt like you gotten offers from people. And the whole point of these offers was so that people could collaborate together and watch you, monitor you. Look. I'm telling you, it's some type of case study. You see this being here? Possibly a galactic being, someone chosen. You're minding your business, you're healing. Someone here has been, I don't know, like tracking you, tracing you, monitoring you. It almost, this is very like Men in Blackish. Like it's as if people are trying to clone you, is what I feel. Nine of Wands. And again, they're doing things to put you in a situation to be wounded so that they can watch you. There's a Page of Swords. This is also that they can watch you and monitor you. Nine of Swords and then the Empress. But see, you're the Empress with the Ten of Pentacles. This person here looks like an Egyptian goddess. You know, I think that now what people are realizing is that you are exactly who they thought you were. They didn't understand, though, the type of power that was going to come from this. It seems like this is some type of spell, a study, or something that has gone wrong. Because a lot of people, I feel, they knew who you were. They put you in certain positions and they thought that you would fall, that you would fail. And instead, you completely awakened to who you are. And now all hell is about to break loose. Because what these people can expect to come to them, because they have tampered with you, your bloodline, your DNA, your life, your friends, your family, or whatever is near and dear to you, the backlash that they are going to receive, I'm telling you, it's unfathomable. These people are going to be met with so much destruction. They never, ever, ever should have touched you. They shouldn't have ever come your way. Somebody, they took a risk. Yeah, justice. Big risk. Five of Pentacles. These people are going to lose everything. Their health, their finances, their friends, they are going to lose everything. Why? Because they tried to take everything from you. And they were successful at doing this. The King of Swords, they had no emotions. These people were like walking, talking robots. They didn't care about what they took from you. I'm telling you, they were obsessed. This is past life energy for some of you. Six of Cups. For some of you, these are just people from your past that you've denied, that you walked away from. These people are so angry with you because you, the Fool card is what just fell. You've taken a leap of faith. You took a risk. You moved away from these people. Look, they're mad. They're angry. And so for many of you, you know, this may not be that deep for everyone, but for some of you, you've had people from your past. I'm telling you, they have been working on you, working against you. You're like a case study to them. And we've had several readings where I've talked about something. You look at here, the moon and the sun, that is light and dark. Some of you, at the very beginning of your journey, you ran across people, they knew who you were. And I have readings about that. I have a Divine Feminine reading that I did a few months ago. And I'm telling you, you met people who were supposed to love you, protect you. They saw exactly who you were. They knew that you were some type of god, goddess, earth angel, they knew something about your destiny and what they decided to do. Here's that Gemini twins energy. They decided to work against you. They decided to work against you. Yeah, three of swords. This is heartbreaking. But you will rise. Oh, trust and believe. And they know it. They know this. Three of cups. For some of you, though, there's a, you're meeting. You're going to start meeting people who are part of the same soul family as you. You may be meeting someone who's very similar to you. And that may be the reason why some of you are waking up to who you actually are. Because, honestly, some of you, you're meeting your twin. Some of you are learning more about your shadow. Some of you, you're learning more about this hidden path of yours. Something in your life, perhaps, has been hidden from you. It's almost like you were taught that something about you or your life was taboo. I'm telling you, it's like something here is a total illusion. And look at these people here with these masks on. It's a lot of shape-shifting energy. I've been picking that up the last year. I feel like shape-shifting is about to become something that's much more common. But the way people have gone about tapping into this type of ancient wisdom and magic to develop certain skills, gifts, abilities, or whatever, they didn't do it the right way. These, for some of you, this is stuff that you can naturally do because of just where you come from and who you are. It's like people have used things against you to rob, steal, kill, and destroy. And I'm hearing you're like the godfather. Like your godfather. I'm hearing you're godfathered in. You just didn't know something. You were godfathered into something. These people, they think that they're getting over on you. And like it's like you were karmic bait for them. They just destroyed themselves. They never should have. You're not like everybody else. They never should have done whatever they did. Three of Wands. Two of Cups, Ten of Cups, Five of Cups, the Lovers and the High Priestess. Something here isn't over. There's an unfinished symphony between a lot of you. Okay? Your journey is just beginning. Your journey of you finding out exactly who you are. For some of you also, your twin flame journey, if you resonate with that, it's beginning. Like, this goes beyond just, oh, you know, this isn't anything karmic. This is you meeting your true, like, divine counterpart. And for some of you, your counterpart is someone who is extremely high ranking in the spirit realm. And they very well could be some, like, a galactic being of some sort, an angel. There is some type of divine mission here. These new, like, twin flame contracts that have come up lately that you've, yeah. I feel that a lot of you too, who perhaps weren't awakened to who you were before, I feel strongly like there's a being, it's more than just a person, that has watched and monitored you. Someone has for sure watched and monitored you for a very long time. They know. It's like they know your secret. The moon here. They know that you weren't born just a regular child. It's almost like you're being guided back home. You know, to some people who don't know, like, this may seem very far-fetched, but it's not. And I keep saying, if you know, you know, because I don't want to get into this too much. I mean, I'm seeing it here. It's like going back to the motherland or the mothership. Like, you're remembering where you came from. It's just interesting. Like I said, you've had people, friends and family, who they knew this about you from the very beginning. They didn't want you to know about it, so they chose to steal from you. Because they didn't think that you would ever realize it. Because I feel like for many of you, so much magic and manipulation and so many illusions have been created so that you wouldn't know who you were. You wouldn't know that you were actually destined for family and greatness. And it's almost like people didn't want you to know that there were other people like you. This is like, you know, being a kid and you were a genius, right? And they told your parents to send you to a school. Maybe it could have been a boarding school because you were meant to learn certain things. Your family, it's like they purposely decided, no, they didn't want you to know who you were. They didn't want you to go away. They wanted to keep you. And now you're waking up and realizing like, wow, you have these gifts, abilities, or something very sacred and ancient about you. But it's stupid because it's like, did you think that like you would never wake up? I guess that's what they thought. They thought you would never wake up. It's like waking up out of a coma. Like, what? Where am I? What is this place? I guess that it's like people thought that if they kept you in the dark for so long that you would just never remember this. For some of you, this is definitely something here. It's more extreme for some people. Well, I don't know if there has been some type of hypnosis or something that's been done. Some of you could have done like past life regression or something like that. And maybe it's helping you to remember. There is some type of spell though, or hypnosis or something. It has been broken. Or just an illusion. I guess just this energetic shift that we're experiencing now, where people are ascending. You know who you are, or you're starting to see and figure out that something about your life is not right. It's like you've been on hold or reservation for a particular place, a particular person, a mission. It's like, I'm telling you, it's like you're not from here, or whoever you're connecting with is not. There's something very specific about your life. It has to be done a certain way. Page of Pentacles here. You're going to get some type of clarity or information here that's going to allow you to have a solid new beginning. Ten of Swords here. It could come with some type of betrayal or heartbreak. Because I do see a lot of destruction happening, especially for the people who along this path, they have crossed you. I'm telling you, it's going to be really bad for these people. Because for some of you, you could have been in your purpose before. Actually, no. Seriously, you weren't supposed to be anywhere before. You're exactly where you're supposed to be. But there's still a lot of karma to pay for the fact that these people, they took advantage of you. Some of you, you have really been taken advantage of. I'm seeing also, too, for a lot of people who have been... Oh, okay. A lot of people have been recruited into groups and businesses, cults, clans, or whatever because of mind control, manipulation, spell work, and other things. And these individuals that have governed these things, they have had people going out doing stuff that they had no business doing, and they knew what they were doing. The karma for that is going to be tenfold. I don't know what type of hidden operation this is, but that's definitely what it's giving me. People have been doing something scientifically or energetically, spiritually, to manipulate people to do things, people who were gifted. As a way to study, but also as a way to pretty much just get away with things that were not of the light. Because a lot of people are like healers and earth angels. The type of protection that you have is what they're after. And I've been saying that how people have been using other people's energy to do the unthinkable. These people have been using your energy to do stuff that you didn't even know you were capable of doing. They're astral traveling, astral projecting, remote viewing. They're doing all kinds of stuff using your energy. It's being blocked now. Seven of Wands. Everything must stop. They can't proceed with this. Why? Because you're awakening, or you've become awakened. There's no more cheat codes. You're tapping in now. Therefore, you have to have all of your own energy for your abundance, for your life, your lineage, like whatever your birthright is. All blockages are removed, and the devil can, you're out of this hellhole that you've been in. Look, the devil, the seven of swords, the eight of cups. Someone here has had you imbalanced. You're free from this. You're free. But I'm telling you for sure that this is either some type of hex or curse. For some, but for some, this is seriously like some type of hypnosis or something that someone has placed people under. This is something globally that's happening. I don't know if this has something to do with like food, drink, or what, but there has been a way that people I'm hearing have been... I'm hearing so many words like infuse and integrate. Something has been integrated into people's reality to. Oh. Yeah. This temperance, this is alchemy, but you see this person mixing things. I'm telling you, it's something energetically. I don't know if it's got something to do with the different towers that we have, or if it's like I said, food, drink, medicine, something, but something is being controlled, administered to see pretty much. It's like the survival of the fittest, and somehow people behind all of this, they know who the earth angels and the healers are. It's kind of odd because it's hard to tell if they are out to get you, to destroy you, like, or are they trying to help you? Do they want to protect you? I can't tell. I think that the agenda for everyone is different. There's definitely a hidden agenda here though. Some of you, nothing in your life has worked because it's definitely something here about partnerships, creation. It's like some of you cannot, you're not meant to produce with certain people. This has something to do with bloodline, or I don't even really know what else to call it. Like, so this is the King of Swords. Judgment. I'm just like, somebody's like, you gotta take your emotions out of this. It's very easy for the mind to go to something negative when you see things that are different, you know. I'll be honest with what I'm seeing here. I don't know if this is, for to protect certain people. It's so much coming up. It's like I was hearing population control, like clone. It's something here. But if I'm honest, for many of you, this is working in your favor. Because wherever you belong is exactly where you're going, where you will have peace, prosperity, and abundance. It's your birthright. But I just feel that when you find out the studies and the operations that have happened behind the scenes that have kept you trapped, it'll blow you away. I don't know who's behind this. It's still very hidden. Like, the King of Swords is usually someone who is fair, who is balanced. They're just, they do things with self-control and moderation. The King of Swords also can be someone who, you know, is completely emotionless, robotic, narcissistic almost. It's, this has something to do with population and creation. It really does. And there are so many different stories that I could think of here, but it's like certain beings are, I'll be honest, and this could be triggering for some, it's almost like slavery. Something here is being segregated, or there's an end. It's like segregation is ending. Like, I can't tell, like, if certain beings are being forced now to be with their own kind, or if there are certain beings that are being forced to be with different types of beings to produce another type of being. Like, and I've had that before, where I said, for some of you, especially on the twin flame journey, you're meant to be with something, I'll say, or someone very different from yourself, because you're meant to produce like this royal breed. This has something to do with certain creations, like actual children and people. It's like building a baby. It has a lot to do with, I'm telling you, DNA. I said DNA, genetics and DNA. I don't know, like, if people want to have super babies. Some people are meant to have like these super babies, these golden children, angels, gods. But there's something here with the mating process that's being controlled. I had a reading about this last year. It was like a 2-hour reading, and I channeled this. Then it's coming out again. King of Cups with the King of Swords. See, again, it's that twin energy. You see one side of a person, you're gonna see the other side very soon. And I think that this has something to do. See, different beings. Okay, it makes sense. I talked about this in the reading the other day when I had that channel message about like these galactic beings. Some of these beings who are making themselves known now in the reality that we know of, they're not classified as good or evil. They look human, but they're not. So it's like what you see isn't actually what you're getting. I don't know if this is you or the person you're connecting. What you see isn't what you're getting. It's not necessarily good or bad. It's just that we're moving into a new reality where everybody looks human, but it's like Man in Black. They're not. Four of Wands and the Page of Wands. Something here is exciting. It brings about a lot of optimism. It's the Four of Wands. It's you going towards union, happiness. I mean, yeah. But the hermit, this has been orchestrated. It's happening all over the world, like globally. This has been orchestrated. The Hierophant, leaders, God, like something has been yeah, the Hierophant, for some reason here, it's like God himself has been looking down on everyone in the world and has decided who has to go with who and what has to be done. And you don't have really any other choice but to quickly jump into mission and do whatever it is that you have to do. This has a lot. I'm getting a lot here about creation. It's something about your genes or, yeah, they're supposed to produce more. This is, yeah, okay, got it. I'm seeing that show, Raised by Wolves, where it's like she comes from a planet and her whole, she was pretty much like, if I'm not mistaken, I guess she looked human, but, you know, she really was like a robot. But she had been giving the, like, she was able to have children. Well, I don't think she actually had kids, but she was called the mother. This has something to do with the mother. You have this gift. You're carrying this gift or this gene. Oh, okay. You're carrying some type of, oh my gosh. You carry some type of gene that I feel that people want to, like, clone. Like there's something here where you're supposed to create, like, children or something. It's something about your gene. And I don't think that you, whether you have children or not, I feel like this is for a lot of women for sure right now. It's something about your, obviously the cups, these are emotions. These are spiritual gifts. These are different beings who don't have, I don't think they have emotions or they don't have the intuition. It's almost like these beings who are, they're massive, they're strong, they're robotic. They're not robots though. I don't know what you call this. How do I describe this? Their gifts is different. Like, you carry this, it's like you're intuitive. They are too, but it's different. But it's like a gene that you have or something that they want to recreate, like clone almost, honestly. Yeah, that's really what I'm getting. There's something where the Eve gene. Is that what it's called? I think it's called the Eve gene. And I'll, like I said, you know, everyone may not like this message and that's fine, but it's something with your DNA. Only African American women are said to carry this gene. It's called the Eve gene, where if I'm not mistaken, isn't it like pretty much stating that pretty much all people, I don't know if this has something to do with like Egyptian bloodlines or what this is, but I feel that it seems like something has been released in the atmosphere in the world, and it's to see who may actually carry some type of gene or something in your DNA that can reproduce different people in this world. And this goes back to like the beginning of time. Like, look at this deck that I have sitting here. This is the deck I used when I did the thread. But you have here the Lover's card and the Temperance. The Star. There's a gene. Something here is a part of destiny. This is some kind of prophecy where you have some type of DNA that I feel people are... There's some kind of operational people are trying to recreate this because they want you to produce a certain type of breed of a child. And this to me is something, it's this person here is more logical, scientific, whatever. The King of Cups is someone who's going to be more, you know, intuitive. This is like something scientific and like spiritual coming together. This has something to do with science and like genetics. So this is to like diversify like the human race. But these, I don't really feel like these aren't full blown humans. What do you call that? You guys, let me know in the comments if you know what I'm talking about. Because there's so much coming to me right now that I'm blanking out. What is it? This is some like Egyptian or like what do you call it? What is it? Is it Nephilims? Is that what it's called? I'm getting the E gene and Nephilims. Like, these are like those huge, huge people. Because what I'm seeing is something, it's massive. It's really, like, this is a very massive part. And I keep saying, I'm like robots, but they're not robots. They're just, it's a different type of being that you wouldn't classify as a human. These are like humans and gods having children. And I just put this in the community post. It's like demigods, like God birth. There's the birth of gods and demigods, and certain people carry the DNA of the genetic makeup to be able to honestly to breed with these beings, these Ace of Pentacles. Listen, I feel like something about a lot of people, your life is about to make more sense. Very so, your life is not your own. It's like people have been created, like you've been created just for whatever it is that you're supposed to create. I mean, I know that sounds like duh, Tori, but no, seriously, it's something big that you're supposed to produce. And it's like you have to turn away from everything that you know now to do this, is how I feel. But it's like you're gonna go into a new reality where it's wish fulfillment and it's equal give and take, but it's something about your genes and DNA. Let me just say this here, and I'm about to get out of this because it doesn't make me uncomfortable at all. It just, I don't know how many people understand this. I mean, I feel like I'm crossing the line. Like, that's how I feel. And when I get messages like this, a lot of times I don't want to put them out. Some of you have supernatural gifts and abilities, whether you know it or not. It's in your DNA. And so you have these different beings that are also, we're all awakening. There's a massive like awakening and ascension that's happening, and people are stepping into this God consciousness is what this is. Thank you, Spirit. God consciousness. And some people are carrying like this, we'll just say like the Eve gene. you have these, or the Nephilims, like these very mysterious, like, beings. And there's other names, you know, people, the Palladians, and just all this different stuff. Well, people are starting to get into, like, DNA is beginning to be activated. And some of you, you're walking amongst people who know you have certain genes or DNA. And I feel strongly like there is, there's a plan for your life. You're a part of a plan. But like I said, it's very easy for us to say, oh, it's so negative. But I feel strongly like this is something that, like, God himself, like, it's like, yeah, I want these different beings to be produced. There's gods and demigods, or like people may say halflings, that are being birthed. So this is that yin and yang. That's why we keep seeing, like, the moon and the sun. It's dark and light. It's feminine and masculine. It's different beings or species coming together to co-create and procreate. And this is a part of this new earth, this new world that's being created. It's people are shifting to God consciousness. That's all I can say. And the what comes to mind, like I said, is Nephilim and the Eve gene. And I would have to Google exactly, like, how to, I guess, explain those. But because I'm not sure, I mean, Nephilims, aren't those considered like fallen angels? So I don't know, like, is okay, I'm gonna leave it here because I'm gonna have to research this. I don't know, I may put this reading out, I may not. I have to research this because I'm hearing Nephilim, but I don't know if I'm not mistaken, like, are those considered like fallen angels? I mean, oh, you know what? Let's check it out. Hold on. Let me Google. I mean, this is discussed in the Bible. So it says Genesis 6:4 reads, the Nephilim were in the earth in those days, and also after that, when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, and they bore children to them, the same were the mighty men that were of old, the men of renown. Fallen angels. So Genesis 6, this is the year of the number 6. According to Genesis 6:1-4, the Nephilim were the children of the relationships between the sons of God and daughters of men. So like I said, these are like gods and humans, you could say, having children, but nobody is actually, I don't think that anybody that this is not totally human. These are all kinds of beings. Which is probably why, oh, I said Eve gene. That will go back to Genesis. Nephilim, the Eve gene, and I don't know. But it says that people have said that the sons of God were fallen angels or demons who bred with human females or possessed human males who then yielded children with human females. Being the offspring of partial angelic heredity, the Nephilim were considered mighty men who were of old. So Are these like demons trying to have babies? I'm sorry. Like I'm not sure. Because I mean, it's saying I fought like demons who are having babies with humans. So, is that what it is? Like, okay. Nephilim, Genesis 6, 1 through 4, were the results of sexual relationships between angels and women. It says, Anakim, the sons of Anak, whom we meet in the book of Numbers, Deuteronomy, and Joshua, are descended from the Nephilim. So these are like fallen angels? I don't know, you guys. I will have to. You can leave in the comments if you can pick up what I'm trying to put down. But I don't want to sit here and just be reading. But that's what I'm getting. Nephilim and Eve genes. So these are some type of beings that are wanting to procreate with women. But these women are not just regular women. These are women who are women who carry the Eve gene. So I mean, that makes you very important, obviously. I mean, it's like gods and God. It's a God consciousness here.